This video is about algorithms. But before we talk about algorithms, we gotta talk about masturbation. And these two things might not seem related, but they are. So if you don't want to watch a video that talks about masturbation somewhat at length, maybe watch this video instead. I think it's great. I made it myself. So I'll give you some time to click that. Also, maybe bookmark this video if you're not going to watch it right now, and then you watch it when you get home, in the privacy of your own home, or on the bus, whatever. Anyways, are you going to watch this one? Okay, so let's talk about masturbation first. Before we talk about masturbation, though, I want to just recognize that there are men that don't have penises, and there are women that don't have vulvas and vaginas. Sex and gender are two separate things, and although they can seem connected, and oftentimes they are connected, they certainly correlate statistically, it's not 100%. Now, with that out there, I do want to recognize that this video is going to be a little bit easier for me to talk about if I refer to men as a shorthand for biological males, so males who have testes. And when I talk about women, I'm talking about women who have ovaries. Basically, people of the genders that they were assigned at birth that have the gonads that they're expected to have by doctors. Okay. But also, that's not the case for everyone. Gender is a wonderful thing. Did you know that the majority of boys and men, by the time they hit age 17, have masturbated? Like, the overwhelming majority. We're talking like 80%. If you're a boy, you probably know this because that was you. It was certainly me. But you might not have known that with girls and women, it's not the same. It's still a majority, but it's not as strong of a majority. And that is because when boys hit puberty, they have a surge of testosterone. We're talking like on the order of 30 to 40 times as much testosterone as has ever been in their bodies. And this is relevant because testosterone is the androgen that causes sex drive. It's part of the cause of sex drive. It's the biological element of what causes sex drive. And so that's also, incidentally, when men have the peak amount of testosterone in their bodies, is when they're younger. This is not the same with women. Women have their peak of testosterone and, incidentally, sex drive in their bodies in about their early to mid-30s. And that's why we have such a big imbalance of sex drive between men and women as people grow up. Biology's wacky, y'all. And I learned all of this because my friend Lindsay over at the wonderful channel Sexplanations occasionally has me research videos and topics around sex and sex education for her. So go watch her channel. But all of that is to set the frame for algorithms. So if you're ready to learn about algorithms, let's go. Now, my other friend Eva also has a sex ed channel called What's My Body Doing? And about a year ago, she posted a video called How to Masturbate for Vulvas, Hands Edition. And she's noticed over the past year that the majority of views that she's gotten on that video have been from men. And when I say majority, I'm talking like 90%, which is like somewhat counterintuitive, because while there are definitely men with vulvas, most men don't. And masturbation tends to be a solo act, although it doesn't have to be. If you haven't masturbated with your partner, maybe that's the thing to do. But we're talking about algorithms. So this is an interesting thing that has happened to the video. One would think that a video about masturbation for vulvas would be seen mostly, or at least more than 3% by women. But it hasn't. So let's talk about why that is. Now, when we talk about algorithms, we have to understand how Google and YouTube's search function works. The way it works is just like any good classification system. It breaks up things. It has an index, basically, of topics that it has, topic words, or what we would call in library science dictionary terms or subject headings. And it identifies these based partly on how often people search, but also based on subject headings that have already been identified. And one of the ways that they are identified is through things like Wikipedia. So Wikipedia has an article about masturbation, and Wikipedia has an article about vulvas. And so YouTube and Google both know that these are topics of themselves, in and of themselves. And so it starts forming statistics around who searches for those terms and content related to those terms. If you want to see how YouTube and Google actually break things up into subject headings, they actually do, like, YouTube and Google do a pretty good job at trying to discern from, like, other terms that you use to figure out what the proper subject heading is. So if I were to put in jacking off into Google or something, it would know, because it has already made the association between jacking off and masturbation, that those are two related terms. And so it might serve me content that is about masturbation, even though it might not say jacking off, even if jacking off is what I put into the search term. It might not be ranked as highly, but I'd still get it somewhere in the results. You can see how this plays out by going over to Google Trends, which is like a really cool thing, actually. It shows you a histogram of how popular different terms are in different searches. And you can do comparisons, too. So you could go over there and search and see how popular masturbation is as a search term versus how popular vulva is as a search term. Yeah, so have a look. By and large, because of the biological effect of testosterone, likely, we know that men search for masturbation a lot more than women do. And so when YouTube is trying to decide who wants to watch a video about masturbation, it's gonna probably show it to men first. And that's to be expected. But one might be like, well, why don't people see videos? Why isn't it showing it to more women when it has vulvas in the title? When women are probably a lot more likely to search for vulva than they are men, or than men are. And that is because probably, sex ed being what it is around the world, women don't often use the term vulva. There is often a lot of mistaking vulva for vagina, or they're used interchangeably, even though they are not the same thing, just to be clear. But because of that, and also because of, like, weird social norms around who gets to talk about sex without being seen as slutty, women don't search for the term vulva as nearly as much as men search for the term masturbation. That's not to say that there aren't women who search for the term masturbation, and that's not to say that there aren't men who search for the term vulva, but by and large, these are pretty separate categories. Now, with that in mind, it's important to note that while we have terms for masturbation, and we have terms like dictionary terms for masturbation and dictionary terms for vulva, we do not have a dictionary term, we do not have a subject heading or a subheading for masturbation for vulvas. And so there isn't a lot of recognition that that's even a thing by the algorithms. And that's by design, as it were. When you use algorithms rather than like people actually curating things, you get exactly what you would expect from a machine that has no concept of what sex or humanity or any kind of sociological thing is. An algorithm is not sentient. An algorithm doesn't even really know what masturbation or vulva are. It just knows that there are some people with specific traits that search for these things. And so to change this, to make this video be found by more women, there are a few things that have to happen. First, we need to start breaking down. We need to have a subheading for the subject heading. So subheading being below it. For masturbation, and we do this in libraries all the time. So you might have masturbation double hyphen, or masturbation M dash women, masturbation M dash men. And you might do the same, like vulvas M dash anatomy, vulvas M dash transgender, all of these different things. But these would be the first way of identifying that these are topics in and of themselves. Another thing that needs to happen is more people need to make content about this. So that's why Eva is so great, is she's doing that. She's making the content to be found. And then more people need to search it and find it and click it and watch it. Probably the reason that she's getting overwhelming views by men, it's not just because men are searching for masturbation, but because men see a video of an attractive woman talking about masturbation. They're like, I'm not going to get into that. I just edited this and realized that I forgot to elaborate that men see a pretty woman talking about masturbation, and then that makes them more likely to click them, which then means that that video is more likely to turn into ad revenue, which is why YouTube shows it to a man over a woman more likely. Okay, back to editing. But that is how things work, and that deserves to be called out. So is there other things that can be done about this? Probably. The thing is, YouTube, so I was at VidCon last year with a bunch of other educational YouTubers, and we got to sit down with some of the developers for the algorithm, the folks who are involved in tweaking it and adjusting it and making sure that it does things justly. And one of my friends, I want to say it was Caitlin Hoffmeister, was that you? asked, does the algorithm discern between whether or not a person is a man, like a person who views a video or searches, is a man or is a woman? And the engineer said, no, in fact, we control for that and we force it to exclude gender and sex and things like that. And I think that they probably do try to do that. But as we can see with this, and this is why I was so excited to make a video about masturbation and the algorithm, is this is a great example of where even though you can try and control for something, you're not going to be able to. You might tell the algorithm, don't sort things by gender. And what's going to happen is going to be like, all right, cool. I will ignore the field where a person specifies their gender, but I will still start breaking them up because people search for different things statistically according to what their gender is. And that's for lots of reasons. That's for social reasons. That's for biological reasons. And masturbation exemplifies that. So even though YouTube might try to control for that, it doesn't always work out for better or worse. And now you know why. So if you like this content, first of all, subscribe. I try and talk about libraries and information science more often in a way that's approachable so that people know what's going on. Also go check out Eva's channel. Also go check out Lindsay's channel. And if you really like this, you might want to consider supporting me on Patreon. Right now I am an unemployed librarian, and so every little bit of money helps. And the more support I get from folks like you, from viewers like you, the more time I can spend making content that informs and educates and makes the world a little better, I hope. So, until next time, thank you for watching, and don't forget to ask questions. Okay, bye.